guys, welcome to my YouTube channel, and today I'll be posting my first video of the very first series on this channel called as University Review Series. I chose UCLA and thought why not start with it. I've taken in consideration all the parameters that I used when I selected UCLA, and after this video a post-admit tip awaits.
Parameter that is essential in determining the university is the coursework and what type of courses does the university provide. UCLA offers wide variety of courses from ceramics, structural materials and electronic materials. I personally like the electronic materials domain because of the job opportunities and prospects it brings up. Electronic materials, especially semiconductors, are booming in this century, and the prospects seem good enough to venture into them, especially for internationals. So these are material science and engineering. These are the graduate level courses which UCLA offers. As you can see, the courses are diverse, but upon closer inspection you will find that most of the courses are inclined towards electronic materials domain. They have physical metallurgy here. These are the courses for physical metallurgy, thermodynamics, and then a part of material characterization. And once again here, material characterization, this is physical metallurgy. As you can see here, there are courses which are based on electronic materials, and some are based on thin films and growth and materials characterization, which is an evergreen branch. Material characterization and thin films is purely experimental in case you have the propensity towards that facet of the discipline. And these all courses are based on electronic materials, and now here, as you can see, all these courses are for physical metallurgy. These are ceramics. They also have courses on nanomaterials, which is also being looked at in the industry as of now. This is again conducting polymers, electronic materials. This course, which is the risk analysis, is very essential because this type of course has a good requirement in every field and every industry. They have computer simulations as well. The nanomaterials. So the best part is that they have a course. Through them, they cover the computational facet as well as the experimental. And one can gain relevant skill set in either or both to leverage their chances of procuring a job after graduation. So although courses are crucial to the learning curve, it is the research experience that makes recruiters come to you. So the advantages I listed, the courses provide both the facets, experimental and computational, and next thing is they are inclined towards electronic materials. This is what led me to choose UCLA. Based on the courses, it can be mentioned that the courses are very good, and you can go for the MS by coursework track, or as they call it, capstone at UCLA. But as I mentioned, the thing which distinguishes your profile from other people is the research experience. So you would want to gain that too. Which brings me to my next parameter. Next parameter that I consider imperative in making informative decision for shortlisting universities is the research profile of professors. It is important to note that the research interests that the professors possess and whether their work is on something which can be consistent for you with your goals needs to be taken care of. So here, as you can see, go to msc.ucla.edu and then here select research areas. So as you can see, these are all the professors with their research interests and what projects they have been working on lately. In master's, since it's a degree for only 2 years, the main focus should be to gain relevant skill set in the field which you are interested towards by going for the research experience, irrespective of the domain it is in. And hence, be open to new things because we never know when an opportunity can drop by. Once you go here, you can see most of them work on some or the other electronic materials, the semiconductor devices or the conducting polymers, with a diverse amount of applications. And the key part is that they have material characterization too. So in case if you choose a professor whose thesis is not in consistency with what you want to pursue after graduation, you can anyways be part of some other research group through Through that, you can gain skills for material characterization, which is definitely an important tool to possess in an industry. So form a decision if you're going for a thesis track on the thesis advisor only after talking to the professors and their students, through which you can have different perspectives about the work they do. In research, it is in your best interest to go over all the profiles of the professors and check whether they work on something which currently is at large in the industry. UCLA professors are more inclined towards electronic materials, as I mentioned before, and exercise both the simulations and the experimentals part of it. So, and also in the era of computers, where data science is trying to take the core departments, the MSc department is also going with the trend, with some of the profs working on machine learning as well to gain results. In addition, the interdisciplinary nature, which is quite evident through the work they do, for example, biomedical combined with materials engineering here, then chemistry combined with semiconductor manufacturing, etc. So this nature is also an advantageous thing. So these thoughts provoked me to choose UCLA in terms of research profiles of professors.
So the third factor I took into consideration is money. The tuition and cost of living both need to be considered in this, and one of major concerns because of various financial backgrounds of people. Think of this as an investment, since you are going to States, and irrespective of whether you will be coming back or not, you will get a return on this investment if you develop an overall personality during your masters and notch up your technical skills as well. This is the major binding factor which actually lets you decide or allows or disallows people to go to their dream university. If this takes precedence over other factors, then I would say choose Texas or Arizona over other states because they are student friendly and economical than California and New York. Otherwise, if this is not a concern for you, then definitely you can choose any university. Lastly, I would just add here that loans, they are not bad. They have a tax rebate advantage which can be availed by your parents. And then the EMIs which generate after graduation have a very insignificant amount. I'm not telling you that you should definitely go for loans, but I'm just telling you the perks of loans. So this was about money. The last parameter that I considered was location. For me, location takes very little precedence or is a primitive factor in comparison to the other three which I mentioned, because internet has made world a smaller place. And as we know, as the pandemic kicked in, everything went from in-person to online. So Zoom stocks have already boomed up. And LinkedIn is one of the most underrated tools here in India. If used prudently, then it can be the sole mode of you procuring a job. Then there's one more website. It's a startup called as Lunch Club, which can connect people for various domains. So you can try that out too. So the goal here is network, get referrals, and get a job. That's what we do in career fairs as well. When companies come, you don't get a job directly or they don't offer you the interview. You talk to them, and then after talking, you start a conversation, and then they remember that conversation. And using that, you connect with them on LinkedIn or any social media website. LinkedIn is more professional. And then you ask for a referral or an interview if the job position is available. According to me, there are only two reasons why someone would consider location as a very important factor. The first is that if they are just going to US for the sole purpose of exploring. The second thing is if they are planning to go start a business there, as to network a lot. Otherwise, in all other cases, I personally think that location doesn't matter that much. So now for the best part of the video, the post-admit tip. After you get the admit, and if you're having dilemma in choosing universities, then it's best to connect with alumni, current students, and the other aspirants which are thinking the same thing as you on LinkedIn, and get different perspectives and different angles of considering a university. Sometimes that might happen that it outweighs all the factors that you've previously considered. For instance, for me it was when I spoke to people, they told me that the professors there, for instance in biomaterials course, they take an end-term examination based on a real-life experience. So the end-term examination for them was based on biomimicry, where you have to choose from nature and find out anything which exists in nature which can help in augmenting the existing technology for the better. This was it. This was the whole university UCLA reviewed for you. This was the first video in the university review series, And if you like such content, then smash that like button and subscribe to stay connected and updated on this content. Let me know in the comments below if you had similar kind of parameters considered for you when you were shortlisting universities, or you had something else also taken into consideration. Let's grow together, and until next time.